Take this charm, the pentagram, the sign of the wolf. It can break the evil spell.
Evil spell, pentagram, wolfbane. Oh, I'm sick of the whole thing. I'm going to get out of here.
Whoever is bitten by a werewolf and lives becomes a werewolf himself.
Oh, quit handing me that. You're just wasting your time.
The wolf bit you, didn't he?
Yeah.
You can't tell me that's a dog.
You were quite right. It isn't a dog.
That's just a legend, though, isn't it?
Yes, but like most legends, it must have some basis in fact. It's probably an ancient explanation of the dual personality in each of us. How does it go? Even a man who is pure in heart and says his prayers by night may become a wolf when the wolf bane blooms and the autumn moon is bright.
Larry Talbot, good guy in the wrong place at the wrong time. Lon Chaney did such a great job because he was so passionate about the role. I mean, he took what could have just been a hairy monster and made you feel for him. On the one hand, you're thinking, they got to kill this guy. On the other hand, you're saying, oh, when they do, I'm going to be really sad. There's something that you can relate to them somehow. They're in some ways sympathetic.
See that scar? That's where I was bitten by a wolf. Only it wasn't a real wolf. It was a man, a werewolf. I killed him. Now I change into a wolf at night when the moon is full.
The werewolf is a really great character. I think most people think, oh, he's a guy turns into a werewolf and kills people, and I suddenly realize, oh, the werewolf is more like a drug addict or an alcoholic where, you know, during the day, he's just fine. He could be your brother, your uncle, your dad. He's really a good guy, but at night, his demons come out. The thing about these monsters is that they're really just people with really bad problems.
I killed Baylor. I killed Richardson. If I stay around here much longer, you can't tell who's going to be next.
The werewolf tradition is the animal or lower half of human nature. The predator, the dark side, what Jung calls the shadow. And that's the animal nature that we try to control. It's the nature of the beast within.
The big thing with the werewolf, we changed who he was and his character a little bit.
Ready, and action!
The hook of any character is always their journey, the arc.
Captain Will!
I was told that I would get to make that transition between this young prince into this, you know, great big, huge, 10-ton, scary werewolf. It was great fun. I thought, excellent.
Cut the rope! Cut the rope!
Run!
Like this, and then one hand, no, then grab your face and just rip your face off and rip your body and you're ripping, ripping it.
We've seen so many times guys growing hair, turning into wolves. I said, we can't do that. The growing hair thing, no matter which way you do it, stop motion or CG, it's just been done to death. And so we came up with our own way. We thought, what if the man starts ripping his skin off and ripping his face right off, and underneath him is growing this werewolf? And then when he needs to turn back, he tears himself apart again, because that's what the guy's doing inside, really, is tearing himself apart.
The way they pitched it was fascinating, the way in which this creature apparently comes from within, which was, and I knew exactly, I thought, oh, great, with that I can run and fly with that.
Will Kemp came in, it's when we were casting in London, and he came in kind of off the street and he just blew us away. He was like, his performance was great. And on top of that, when we asked him to turn into a werewolf, he was contorting all over the place.
No, wait, I only have a moment.
But Bill, can there's a
werewolf? Never mind that, listen to me. I know Dracula's secret.
It wasn't until later we found out that he's a ballet dancer. He's done Swan Lake. He's done, I'm like, oh, that makes sense now.
And background!
And action!
Whenever you try to reinvent something so well known, you always try to at the same time give it justice and learn as much as you can about when it was created and why, but also to make it relevant for for this particular time.
If you love those characters, you're going to love them in Van Helsing, I'm telling you right now, but if you love that sort of stuff, if you love the old original Universal horror monster movies, this movie's just going to like blow your socks off.
I know a man who has the power to help you.
No one could help me.